We got a lot of special announcements, but I'm sure that you're interested in the show that's coming up. So let's greet them here at Sunset Bar and give them a great big welcome. Hank Williams from the Mississippi Cowboys.
Pennsylvania. This first time we've been here since way back the first of last summer. We're really glad to see all you folks visiting with us. Got all the drifting cowboys, all two of them here. This one here and this one here. Here. We borrowed one here. Wanna start? Thank you. Let me get this yoke gun done and I'll start some. I ain't got used to them yet. Wearing too long. Here's one I wrote last year and made me and the boys quite a few biscuits. I hope you'll remember it. Hey, good looking, huh? Let's go.
Deluxe edition of a Sid and Roebuck catalog. I started out the door with it, and he said, "Whoop!" Said, "I done thought of something else. I got it right." I brought that bundle back, and down at the bottom of the last page, he put, "P.S., darling, I'm sending you a check for 1,000 hugs and kisses." Now, that helped the situation. That made him feel good. I carried that bundle to the post office, and they charged me $4.68 to mail it. It was worth it. He had more life in him for the next about 5 days than all the boys put together. And then about the fifth morning, the bellboy woke us up. Bellboy woke us up. Said he had a special delivery airmail for Jerry Rivers. We all jumped up to see what it was. It was from his wife. If I'd have been heard, wouldn't go write no more than that. I wouldn't even wrote to him. All in the world she said was, "Thanks, darling, for the check." Said the Iceman cashed it this morning. He ain't felt too awful well since then. Let's see if we can cheer him up a little bit. His name is Jerry Rivers. There he is. Here's a young man that you all know. He's been kind enough to assist us here. Make it sound like there's more of us. We so appreciate it. Let's give a great big hand to Ross Percy, will we? Thank you. Look, right now, we're going to turn Jerry loose here. Down in Alabama, where I was born and raised, on Saturday night, all the neighbors used to go over to just one neighbor's house, and they'd tear the bedsteads down, stack all the furniture out in the yard. Mama'd go in the kitchen and get some cornmeal, throw it on the floor. And business would pick up. Business used to pick up to a tune something like this called Fire on the Mountain, Run, Johnny, Run, huh?
Recorded it
It ain't Jambalaya. The name of it is Jambalaya. Here it is. Hit it. I'll tell you what jambalaya is, if you want to know. It's something like beef stew. No, they make it out of shrimp, crabs, crawfish, everything in the world. They just put it all in a pot and stir it up and cook it, and they call it jambalaya. That's what it is. Right now, here's the thing. I ain't slept not all night like I told you, and I ain't tried nothing like this. I'm allowed to bust a tonsil on this thing, but I'm going to try it. We got some requests for it. That's what we come out here for, try to please you folks. That's what we try to do everywhere we go. We try to do the songs that you ask for. Boys, you remember Long Gone Lonesome Blues? Well, that's a tempo, huh?
And I You wouldn't stay away as much as you.
I'd like to remind you, we're going to be here all day for shows right on and on. And on each show, we're going to switch songs. We ain't going to do the same ones on each show. So you liable to hear chew tobacco. Can't stand it. It makes me sick. Can't afford it. Friends, on all of our shows, we always do one or two of the old hymns. Here's one of my favorites. One I wrote a long time ago. Roy Acuff recorded it for Columbia. It got awful popular a few years ago. Boy, and myself going to team up here. Bobby, you and Roy know the word. Just join in with it. One I wrote, I imagine 4 years ago. There it is. I saw the light.
Here it is, the Lovesick Blues.